The gathering hymn is Send Us Your Spirit.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our celebration this morning. This is kind of the reality that we're in at the present time, and for our own safety and all that other stuff, we have to do what we have to do. And so, unfortunately, hopefully in a way that the times will change rapidly and we'll get back to a better place. And so let's begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord be with you all. And as we prepare to celebrate the great mystery of Christ's love for us, we pause first of all to acknowledge our failures and ask the Lord for mercy, for pardon, for strength to do better. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, who by the mystery of today's great feast sanctify your whole church in every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth. And with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now, once more, the hearts of all believers. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak in different tongues, as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused, because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement, they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, in the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as the travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs, yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God, who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, to also Christ. For in one Spirit we are all baptized in one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please remain seated for the Pentecost sequence. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, everybody. As Father Francis said last week, some of you were here, some of you weren't. Welcome back. You know, it's been a difficult time, but it's good that we have public masses again. And I know it's difficult. I'm not used to seeing a bunch of people with masks on. But you know, even though we interact with our families and our communities, it's just good to see the body of Christ of St. Joseph again. So welcome back. I don't know if you guys noticed or not, but things were changing here, right? You see something different this week through our liturgical calendar. We're still in Easter time, but what's different? We're wearing red. And I also noticed several of you guys coming into church wearing red, which signifies the solemnity of Pentecost, which is a very important feast in our church. A lot of the scholars believe that this is the beginning. This feast was the beginning of our church, the way it was established. And the Holy Spirit ascended down to the disciples. And we're going to get into that a little bit later. But our Lord instituted this church. And the Holy Spirit came in and gave it the authority, inspired the church to go forward. And just to tip off on a few things that happened when we established our church. Well, first of all, the New Testament readings were inspired by the Holy Spirit. The New Testament readings that we read. The book of the Bible was composed by our church, inspired and given the authority to the people that did that by the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God. The way we do liturgy has been established by the authority of the Holy Spirit. The sacraments that we have right now, the way we celebrate our sacraments, have been established through the years of this church, guiding us by the Holy Spirit. So it's a very important feast, very important solemnity. And I think we always have to go back and remind ourselves, who was this Jesus Christ that has instituted our church? You know, we've gone through Lent. We went through Holy Week. We went through the passion and death and resurrection of our Lord. And you know, our Lord struggled. He suffered and he died. So let's go to this scene in the gospel today. We believe it's after the walk of the Emmaus. The disciples were walking with Jesus and they didn't recognize him. And then when he opened, broke the bread, they recognized who he was. And he said, go back and tell everyone that he was going to meet with them. So here we are. The disciples are locked behind closed doors because they were scared. I mean, good gracious, their leader had just been crucified by this group of people. So you can imagine how scared they were. And then all of a sudden, their leader shows up. He doesn't open a door. He walks through it. I don't know about you, but that really might scare me. And not only that, most of these guys ran away. They didn't walk with Jesus through the crucifixion. So you would think maybe they might be worried about Jesus just maybe reprimanding them just a little bit. Or Jesus just might be frustrated that he was crucified and the pain he went through. But that's not what he did. The first words out of his mouth was what? Peace be with you. So let's get this straight. The God that established our church is a loving God. Is a merciful God, is a forgiving God, and a God of peace. So we always have to remind ourselves about how this church and who established this church. So let's go to the first reading with the disciples. If you expand the reading a little bit before and after this particular reading, you'll find out that it was very specific. You know, Judas betrayed Jesus, so they went and got another disciple. Then they laid hands on him. There was about 125 people, we were told in the previous reading, the previous scriptures. Mary, the mother of God, was there. And they were in one place, and they were praying. Specifically said they were praying. Now let's put things in context again. Our Lord told the disciples that he is going to send an advocate. Expect it. So obviously, Ascension happened. Last Sunday, we realized the feast of the Ascension of the Lord. He ascended into heaven, and they were waiting for this advocate. So they're sitting there, and all of a sudden, there came from the sky a noise like a strong wind, and it filled the entire house. And as they gathered in this large crowd, they were confused. Now, there's a lot of lessons and a lot of teachings in this reading. But if you go further, you're going to see that a lot of the people had, they came from different parts of the world. They had different languages. But they all understood each other. Now, you make a comparison to the Tower of Babel in the Old Testament. When man, his arrogance, thought we could build a tower and get to heaven, they were all speaking of the same tongue, and what did God do? He didn't allow any of them to understand what they were talking about, and they scattered them. Because the arrogance of man created them to be scattered. We come into the Feast of Pentecost, the Spirit is upon them, and they're unified. Why? Because Jesus had just suffered and died for our sins. A lesson here. A lesson here. If we're pure of heart, unity will remain. If all of a sudden we're in sin, unity cannot happen. Very important lesson. So the Spirit came down upon them. And if you continue to read in the Acts, you'll see that Peter... What? He was the guy that was supposed to take the keys of the kingdom and start this church. But he wasn't doing anything. He denied Jesus 3 times. When the Spirit came upon him, what happened? He transformed. He transformed. His fear went away. His anxieties went away. And he started preaching. And he started giving this message of repentance. And he became our first pope, our leader of our church, where he was so afraid to do that before. But with the strength of the Holy Spirit, the advocate that our Lord promised him, he became bold in his faith. And the other disciples as well. And if you keep reading in the Acts, 3,000 people were baptized. 3,000 people were baptized. So then we got dispersed. Disciples went off to preach the good news throughout the region. Oh, but it wasn't that easy, was it? Our church was being persecuted. The way, as they said at the time, was being persecuted. Every disciple, except maybe for one, was martyred. We know Peter was crucified. He said, crucify me upside down because I don't need to be crucified like my Lord. Do it in a worse manner. And then what happened? This guy named Saul, the guy that was persecuting these people all over the place, persecuting Christians, the Holy Spirit came down upon him and had a conversion. And now he becomes one of our great evangelizers of the Christian way. Reflect on the power of the Holy Spirit. Reflect on the Lord that he gave us this strength, because once we were baptized, that Spirit indwells in us. And it gives us the strength to go forward in this life. And we have to embrace the Holy Spirit. We have to pray to the Holy Spirit to help us get through our issues of life. And as we sit here now, been quarantined for a month and a half, maybe longer, we're seeing people that are lonely. We're seeing people that are anxious. We see people that are out of work. We see people that are just frustrated with everything, and I'm never going to deny anybody how they feel, because how they feel is how they feel. But there are a lot of people that are just frustrated. We hear confusing messages from the media. We are living in a very confused time. And now, all of a sudden, we have these riots, and another whole thing is getting ready to escalate. Allow the Holy Spirit to be your guide. Pray to the Holy Spirit to give you the power to overcome anxieties, to overcome loneliness, to overcome your struggles. To overcome, if you have a marital issue, pray to the Holy Spirit. And I'm going to be honest with you. Sometimes your prayer may not be what you ask for. But we know that the Holy Spirit will give you what's best for you. And I'll give you an example. My mother was battling kidney disease for almost 2 years. And we prayed hard for her to be healed. And it just didn't work. But she was so, and the Spirit was so deep in her heart that when it came time that there was nothing else the doctors could do, she brought his family together and she said, "I'm done." She basically said, "I lived to fight. I did everything the doctors told me to do, and it's just not working." So hospice came in 2 days later. Our prayers weren't answered. If you look at it, she wasn't healed. She went in and she got incoherent in about 3 days, a little over a week. Judy and I went every evening to see her in case she was going to pass. But one Sunday, we had mass all around her in her living room. She was incoherent. We had mass. We gave her a real small piece of Eucharist. She hadn't swallowed in a day and a half. She swallowed. That was 11:30 in the morning. She had her grandchildren, her children, some of her great-grandchildren around her. All through this process, our little grandchildren and one of my sister's grandchildren, they asked me to take them for a ride on the golf cart. We went down a road and they start picking up wildflowers, and I thought they're going to go take them to their mothers. They brought it and set it on grandma's bed. 1:30, the caregiver told us that it was time, come. So we had all the siblings and our wives and our husbands come. We shut the doors. But nothing. We were gathering around. We had everybody in her room. Everybody in her room at 3 o'clock for the Divine Mercy Chaplet. And she passed. And I'm going to tell you, the prayers we prayed to the Holy Spirit were answered. Because her death was amazing. I want to die that way. So do not underestimate the power of the Holy Spirit. He is our Lord in our lives now. Embrace Him or her, however you want to name it. If you have issues, pray. But pray with zeal. And remember what our mission is in this world, in this church, is to go out and teach the good news to people. Through the prayer, our Lord said to His Father right after the Last Supper. And if you read it in John 17, our Lord says, "Dear Father, I don't belong in this world any more than they do. We're not made to live in this world. We're made to be in eternal life with our Father." Keep the zeal up for your faith. As tough as it may be, keep the zeal up for your faith. Teach the good news to people. Do never give up on anybody, because you know what? Our Lord didn't even give up on his disciples when they turned their back on him. Show peace to people. Show love and show mercy, and please be forgiving. I read a reflection this morning from the Bread and Body, from the Presentation Ministries, and I want to read it. Pentecost is essential because without the Holy Spirit of Pentecost, we will not be united and the world would not believe in Jesus. We would not prophesy. That is, we will not receive messages from God. We'll never pray as we should. We will never have the power to be witnesses for our Lord, for Jesus Christ. And we surely cannot say Jesus is our Lord without the Holy Spirit. We cannot please God. And of course, if we don't have the Spirit amongst us, we don't realize and witness the gifts and the fruits that the Holy Spirit will give us. So we need Pentecost. And we need a new Pentecost now. For our lives right now. So please, open your hearts and receive the Holy Spirit.
Let's stand for our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, eternal Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We do thank you, Almighty God, for all blessings we receive, especially for hearing all of our prayers.
That the Holy Spirit may always guide our popes, our pope, our bishops, priests, and deacons to be faithful heralds of the Holy Gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That local and civil governments suffering from the recent civil unrest and instability may be given the gifts of peace and tranquility, which secures the rights of all their citizens. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we who have the Holy Spirit as our advocate may in turn be advocates for the vulnerable, the forgotten, and the unborn. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are ill may turn with faith to the saving power of the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who have died and for all who comfort those who mourn may find comfort in the Lord's loving embrace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we do pray for all military, police officers, and firefighters, that they all be protected from harm and do their jobs with compassion and patience and understanding. We also pray for all those that have died, especially those in our family and friends. And we pray for all of us who are gathered here, for all the prayers that are in the secretness of our hearts that only God can hear. And we pray that our Blessed Mother may continue to watch over our families and help us as well. And through the Holy Spirit, may we continue to be guided and may we continue to be taught and become one in Christ our Lord, through whom we pray, through Christ our Lord, forever and always. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us our bread of life. Blessed be God forever. And blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Let us all together pray that our sacrifice of this bread and wine may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of the sacrifice and graciously lead us into all truth. Grant this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those whom you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. The same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God, and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people, exults in your name, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, And all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son may be filled with his Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, the apostles, martyrs, and saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Gustavo, our Bishop, with the clergy, religious brothers and sisters, and all people everywhere. Listen graciously to the prayers of your family, whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To all of our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. For there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestowed on the world all that is good. through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us all stand to pray the words that Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that with the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you did say to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. We ask you not to look upon the sins which we may have committed from the faith of your whole church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are all of us who are called to receive the supper of our Lord. Lord, Well, I hope you have a blessed week and stay safe and all those things that we're being told to do. And I'm glad to have been here for you this morning. I didn't say it at the beginning, but I'm Father Ken. I normally do work for the military, but they're still kind of trying to figure out what to do, which they probably will be still doing it around Christmas. So still trying to figure out what we're going to do, you know. So that's the military. But anyway, I hope you have. But like I said, pray for our country. It's hurting right now. We thought we had it bad with the coronavirus, and then all of a sudden we had the unemployed, which are 40 million or so right now. And some of the people have lost their salaries, and some of the people have you know, lost their jobs, and on and on and on. It's a very difficult time. And then the protests, and which is okay, but at the same time, the violence that goes that have been gone with it by some is not. So anyway, our country is hurting. People need to be heard. And hopefully this is a wake-up call for the people that govern us, that they will hear the people. Because most of the people out there are not you know, protesting perhaps just because of what happened to Mr. Floyd, but perhaps are, you know, also protesting about you're not listening to us, you're not hearing us, you're not helping us. And so anyway, like I said, we still need to pray for our country that that all will be well, and that that we'll get back on track the way we should. Let us pray. O God, who bestows heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given us, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured upon us may retain all of its force, and that this spiritual food may gain us abundance of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you all. May Almighty God bless you now and always, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your lives. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Our sending forth is Lead Me, Lord, and please remain seated at the end of Mass and wait to be escorted out by the ushers.